Firewater friends, I hope you're doing lovely today. Thank you for joining me for another group session. So if you're Cancer, Scorpio, or Pisces, these messages will be for you. Now friends, if you haven't joined me for a group session before, all good. Just understand not all messages will resonate, and that's totally cool. If you need a private session, please check me out at my website, kellyfergusonreadings.com. And of course, if you like these messages, please don't forget to support me so I can keep supporting you. Whether that's liking, sharing, subscribing, following, I'm happy to have you with me. And thank you to all my new subscribers and all my new followers for joining me. I hope you enjoy these messages. I hope you feel they resonate in your best good. So, water signs, it's December now. So let's take a look at what December is gonna hold for you. I'm gonna take a look across the month. So, you know, beginning, middle, and the end of the month. And of course, we're gonna look at some overall energies. So, water signs, please. What is the overall energies for the month of December? Water signs, ooh, look at that. Bam, already in your face. Oh, ho, ho. Check this out. Water signs, there's a couple of things going on for you guys. This is gonna be, whew, okay. New moon and promise. Damn. Okay, so there's two levels that we can look at this. Some of you might be starting off in a new relationship and really trying to move forward in terms of making promises, not only to yourself, but to this other person. Promises can look like, you know, promising to each other and solidifying a connection or a romantic connection. What this can also mean is setting out promises and new rules and guidelines for yourself of going into agreements, whether it's romantic or not, of what you want to see happen, about you standing strong in your power and getting what you want. There is a message here of having some self-esteem things that need to be looked at, or connecting to your own power and standing in your power. And I feel that some of you are overcoming some things in the past where maybe you weren't standing in your power, either in romantic relationships or in partnerships of whatever way, and now you're trying to approach this again with a new set of eyes and saying, I'm doing it differently this way. And what came out with this as well? Shaman, ancient healing wisdom. And isn't this exactly the flavor of this? Because when you try something new, when you make promises to yourself, it's because you are healing. It's because you've seen things that have happened in the past that didn't work out in your best good, and you're making a promise to yourself to move forward and do it in a different way so that you can be healed, so that you can be happy, so that you can be balanced, right? Right. I love how water cards almost always show up for you, water signs. That's awesome. I love it. So, water signs this month. Let's take a look. Let's take a look. What are the details? What is going to happen for our water signs this month, please? Show me the beginning of the month, the mid-month, and the ending of the month. Okay, hold on. We got something flipping up already for you guys. Okay. All right. Hang on. No, I'm gonna do this again. Water signs, please. Water signs. What's the month going to look like? Do you see this? Do you see how this happens? It like literally jumps out of my hands and lands on my hand. So there's a message for you here. Oh damn, water signs. Holy shit. Okay, so this is getting this is getting exciting right away. I'm seeing water all over the place. Okay, oh, all right, we got stuff to talk about, water signs. We got some stuff to talk about. All right, let's just sit with this for a second. All right. Yep, I see that. Okay. All right. Okay, water signs. So, you've made some new promises to yourself to not go into the same repeated patterns, to not go into the same, you know, romantic things in terms of not getting what you want. Again, partnerships, whether this is romantic partnership, whether this is, you know, career or family type partnerships, but definitely for some of you, this is romantic stuff, okay? I feel that you guys might be going into another cycle, but you know how the universe continues to bring you these same lessons in different people or in different circumstances to see what are they gonna do with this now? Now that they learned about this and this and this in the past and they've experienced it, are they gonna go into the same tricks? Are they gonna fall on the same, trip up on the same stuff or not? And I feel like this is what's gonna happen. But this is why these messages are coming out, water signs, because if you can get a heads up and see what you're going into, then maybe you will stop it before anything gets too out of control. Okay, so good things that we're starting off with, really good things that we're starting off with. Nine of Pentacles right away. Damn, water signs, like this is you and your energy. Okay, this is like this, right? So you making promises to yourself of I can do this by myself, I'm independent. And it doesn't mean you don't want to be with someone or make a partnership, but you have come to a full circle to understand who you are, what you have to offer, what you bring to the table, and you are not dimming your light now for anyone anyone or for anything. You are also going to wait for the right opportunities or for the right people, and you're not just jumping at anyone who gives you attention or at the first offer that comes along. This is lovely. And check this out, right beside the Nine of Pentacles, bam, Ace of Cups. I love it, right? And we're talking love stuff, so there's definitely romantic stuff on the table for some of you. You might have somebody catch your eye in the first week or so, water signs, and be like, hey, my heart go pitter-pat type of stuff, right? But I feel that there's going to be a little bit more than meets the eye to this relationship here, because even in the first week, right after the Ace of Cups, we got the Five of Wands. So this is drama. This is headbutting. This is battling. This is either you battling yourself or you legitimately battling other people. I don't mean you're getting into fist fights. Obviously not what I'm talking about. But you might see that right away, you know, I like this person. I like this offer. But then as you start to scratch the surface and get to know this person a little bit better, or know the offer a little bit better, you're starting to see some holes that you don't like. You're starting to see some things that you're like, oh, that's part of the package. And I feel that what happens with this is, like, I want to say like three strikes and you're out. Because, you know, like, we can't expect anybody to be perfect for us. Everybody's got their stuff that they bring along, right? But this is kind of like telling me you see one thing and you're like, okay, no biggie. You see something else and you're like, all right. And then you see something else and you're like, okay, I see a trend here, okay? So I feel like your lesson here is, when you see smoke, there's probably fire. Don't stick around for the proof, friends, okay? Because I'm telling you, stuff's gonna go down if you don't listen to these hints of something doesn't feel right. Because the very next card that comes up, speaking of fire, bam, we got the Tower. Didn't I even say it, right? So the Tower represents sudden dramatic events that show up out of nowhere, okay? But this isn't exactly out of nowhere. You see it coming, okay, water signs? So again, this is where you have to get smarter and you have to learn from what you did in the past and make new promises to yourself to stand in your power, okay? So this is a real deal type of thing, water signs, and I don't want to see you get all tripped up. But mid-month, there is going to be something that happens. So if you solidify your connection to this person or to this contract, whatever this is going to be, and you do it with feeling already that something's off, then guess what? It's going to be off and it's going to blow up in your face. Don't do it, okay? Because honestly, look at what's in the middle of the spread. Eight of Cups, you end up walking away, right? I love that you end up walking away sooner than later, but if we can avoid this whole crash, boom, bang, I think that's a much better strategy. Because outside of this, here you are, Ace of Swords in reverse, going, what the hell just happened? I don't understand. This doesn't make sense. I'm feeling confused, okay? Well, if you read between the lines, and when something, you know, looks like a duck, quacks like a duck, it's probably a duck, all right? So if you are learning from past experience, you're not going to dip your toe into these waters when they start to feel cold or unsettled, okay, water signs? There's lessons to be learned here, okay? Please, please listen to this, because I love you and I don't want your hearts to be hurt. Because after this big Tower moment and you walk away and you're feeling all confused, you continue to be confused. You're confused, but you're like kind of over it in some ways. You're like, okay, this is behind me, etc. But you're still kind of reeling from it. You might even be kicking yourself going, I kind of felt this. I kind of had the feeling that this person was off or this offer was off, okay? And then you're in recoup mode, all right? And then Knight of Wands in reverse, your personal momentum and your personal, your personal progress and evolution starts to kind of go back a bit. Even though you might come out of this unscathed if you act earlier, this tells me that if you don't act earlier than later, then you might kind of go down in the dumps and kind of feel like, you know, duped a little bit from this situation. And we don't have time for that, water signs. We really don't, okay? And honestly, then it turns into this. Eight of Pentacles in reverse. So you not focusing, you being down in the dumps to now, it's affecting you tangibly, meaning it's affecting you as in, I feel like I don't want to go to work, or I don't feel motivated to do this, I don't be motivated to do that, okay? Water signs, there are lessons to be learned here, okay? And these, excuse me, these messages aren't coming out to say, oh my God, look at all these bad things. 100%. These messages are coming out to say, you've learned this lesson before. We are giving you another turn around the track to see how you handle it this time again. So friends, water friends. Take action sooner than later this month. Don't hang on to any drama or negativity. As soon as you see it, you gotta nip it in the butt. Because if you don't nip it in the butt, you start this chain reaction of BS, and you're gonna look back at this and go, why did I do this? Why did I do this? I knew better. I felt it. I saw it coming. You do, right? It's happened before. You've changing your ways, right? You're starting off great by going, I got this. You got to stay in this energy, right? As soon as you go out of that energy, it all goes wonky, water signs. And you don't need that. Don't need that at all. So, animal messages for our beautiful water signs. What do our animal messengers have to say for us? Any action, any advice, any guidance? What do our spirit animals want us to do? Oh, look at that. You see how this, I'm telling you, water signs, I'm telling you, okay? Now, this is completely relevant to you, okay? First card, Raven and Magic. And this says, own your power. What have I been saying this entire reading? Own your power. Raven is about change and transformation, okay? You are going from this, next thing you know, you're going to this. Don't take a step backwards. Do you see where this is going, right? Honestly, Nine of Pentacles, Eight of Pentacles in reverse. That's a big backwards slide. You are making changes. You have already made some of these changes. So integrate these changes into your life and into your decisions. And therefore you will be the change and you won't call the same sort of stuff to you, okay? And then another beautiful winged coming for you, Dove and Serenity, water signs. Then it says here, slow down, pause and breathe, okay? So just like I'm saying here, and even in the Ace of Cups, if you've ever noticed, there's lotus flowers all at the bottom, which talks about taking it slow, a slow journey, okay? So these messages are all saying you can avoid drama if you listen to yourself and if you learn from your past mistakes and don't repeat them. It's beautiful to give people second chances or to rise above and to, you know, want to see the best in somebody, but if you get the feeling right away that something is off, it is off. Don't waste your time, water signs. We don't want to see you go down and waste any more time with something that's not for you. I love you so much, water signs. You're perfectly in alignment with good stuff. Don't get distracted. Water signs, I hope these messages helped you out and give you some faith and give you some direction on what's coming this month so you can avoid any snags. If you enjoyed this message, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And if you need a private session, check me out at my website, kellyfergusonreadings.com. I'll check you out later, water signs.